We, as additive manufacturing industry, need to think about the social and environmental impact of our technology. As we develop new products and technologies to help our customers create innovative and meaningful applications, sustainability needs to become top of mind. Multinational corporations are becoming increasingly influential, and with that influence comes responsibility. Additive manufacturing provides companies with an instrument to manufacture in a more sustainable way, both socially and environmentally. AM empowers people locally through decentralized production. It improves people's health and well-being through personalized care, and it enables higher quality jobs. Additive manufacturing also supports a manufacturing process with less waste through mass customization and optimized distribution. And while AM is a positive force that helps companies to operate more sustainably, that's not enough. The AM industry itself needs to step up too, by developing new and innovative ways to reduce its impact. And that will be the challenge, not only for 2020, but for the years to come. I'm excited to see more and more industry leaders who recognize that and who develop initiatives to reduce energy consumption, to increase usage of recycled powder, and to create the workspaces of the future. In C, 3D printing technology has no morality. It can easily be abused to go for dirty, close, cheap solutions that take away choices from people and centralize economic power and profits. We have to ensure that the opposite happens. And so moving forward, the question is not, is AM a more sustainable manufacturing technology? The question becomes, what can we do to make AM more sustainable?
With uncertain economic times ahead of us, manufacturers will focus more on reducing cost and mitigating risk, especially those manufacturers that operate in industries that are more sensitive to fluctuating demand. In the crisis of the late 2000s, AM was hit quite hard, because at the time it was mainly a prototyping technology, and as companies cut investments in R&D costs, the demand for prototyping fell. Today this is different. AM is no longer only about prototyping. It has become a complementary technology for the creation of final products, offering specific design and manufacturing benefits. And so in economic uncertain times, AM no longer represents a cost and a risk, but an opportunity. Compared to traditional manufacturing technologies, AM doesn't follow the economies of scale. It requires very little startup capital. On-demand production means there is less need for stock or inventory. And localized production can absorb the impact of fluctuating tariffs. So while there may be uncertain economic times ahead, we believe there is a bright future ahead for AM as a tool to help manufacturers reduce cost and mitigate risk.
Data is power. And with increased adoption of 3D printing and more sensors providing improved insight into the 3D printing build process, we are collecting more data than ever before. Collecting data in itself is not enough. We need to make that data actionable. AI is a promising and incredibly powerful tool to digest large datasets and to create actionable insights. But this requires not only large datasets, it's also requiring a deep understanding of processes, or in the case of AM, the 3D printing build process. Today, there are certainly instances where AI helps to advance AM. But before we can truly adopt AI into AM, we need to work on developing better insights and also get a better understanding of the many parameters and algorithms that define the 3D printing process. This will require continued investment in research and innovation, but also cross-industry collaboration. In that sense, I would say that data is the new Alaska. It's a big, rough, dangerous terrain where you can find gold if you really mine hard, but also if you know what you're looking for. Only when we truly understand this and develop actionable insights on how to make the process faster, how to make it more stable, how to make it more predictable, then we will be able to unleash the full potential of AI into AM.
In recent years, the technology has developed on many crucial fronts: faster machines, new materials, and more finishing options. Today, we see all of these advances coming together to create an exciting new climate of innovation. This is excellent news for the AM industry, not only because it allows us to enhance existing applications with improved production processes, but it also sparks developments for entirely new applications that were simply unthinkable or unachievable before. A great example is the new TPU materials for mass customization. In previous years, we were able to print with TPU, but the process was rather unstable and therefore unscalable. Now, HP's MGF machines, BASF's new TPU materials, and Materialize's knowledge of process and design are the perfect mix to create and scale new applications such as footwear, athletic gear, and safety equipment. These holistic advancements in AM machines, software, and materials are creating a perfect storm of opportunities for AM across industries. In previous years, consumers may not have known or cared about the manufacturing process behind their product of choice. Now, with increased performance, aesthetics, and active participation in the personalization process, AM is about to get real. In 2020 and the years to come, people will discover and enjoy products they never imagined before.
As companies scale their AM operations, they increasingly rely on automation. But the potential to scale is limited by the post-processing, which today is still mostly a manual process. Scaling this manual process by simply adding people increases costs, variability, and doesn't increase reliability. If you want to scale production, the only way forward is to automate post-processing. This is especially the case in mass customization. But that's easier said than done. If, for example, you're working in eyewear, different customers may want different colors for their personalized eyewear, which complicates the process even more. Also, even if you talk about mass customization, the total output is still relatively small. We believe that the time for automating post-processing is now, and at Materialize, we've been heavily investing in these processes. An example of our recent commitment to automation is that we robotized our entire cleaning line in our medical production to ensure the highest possible quality standards. Fortunately, Industry 4.0, with increased automation capabilities in robotics, is creating new ways to automate the post-processing steps. This will require time, effort, and new investments, which will only pay off if AM mass manufacturing starts to scale, which it will. And that's why investing in automated post-processing is vital.